Welcome to the Line Array Calculator 3 feature update video for version 3.1 and 3.2. Since the original release of LAC3, there have been a ton of under-the-hood bug fixes, user interface refinements, and performance improvements. For example, we have improved the LAC3 venue file compatibility with the JBL ArrayLink mobile application and performance manager. The calculation engine has been rebuilt to take advantage of multi-core processors, resulting in up to 10 times faster calculation speeds. The acoustic prediction bandwidth has been increased to 16 kHz, giving a much better representation of system performance. A new user interface improvement in the mapping section of LAC helps to simplify the process of building your array. We have added a system selection drop-down menu. Once your system type is chosen, it filters out all of the irrelevant speaker types, saving you time and clarifying your options. Several user interface improvements have been made to the circuit grouping function of LAC3. Speakers that are now part of the same circuit group receive a single gain control for level adjustments and a single DSP button for access to the line array control panel. This creates a cleaner, more focused layout. To create circuit groups, hold the Shift or Control key on your keyboard and then select the speakers you wish to group. Once highlighted, click the Create Group icon or use the Control G keyboard shortcut. When LAC files that contain groups are imported into Performance Manager, all grouping and DSP adjustments are automatically loaded into the corresponding amplifiers. A listening height parameter has been added to planes set as audience areas. This avoids having to offset the venue planes for ear height and allows for easy switching between seated and standing positions. To change the listening height, first select a plane and then select seated or standing. The actual height for each position can be set globally in the application options. Several improvements have been made to better support some of the VTX A12 accessories. The VTX VT-GND ground stack accessory has been implemented, allowing for the design of ground stacked A12 systems in the ground stack array mode. To create an A12 ground stack array, first select the ground stack array mode and then select VTX A12 from the system selection drop-down menu. This will add an A12 system to the venue along with the GND accessory. Several UI improvements have been made in this mode, allowing for easier box-to-box angle selection, as well as overall array aiming. Support for the VTX A12SB suspension bar now allows for several new use cases. All suspension bar usage options can be selected in the configuration page. Typically, the A12 suspension bar is attached to the bottom of an array to implement pullback for applications requiring substantial down tilt. The suspension bar can now also be used at the top of the array as an array frame. This can save cost, lower the array weight, and create a cleaner design. Depending on the array's center of gravity, it's sometimes possible for a single suspension bar to be used to suspend an entire A12 array. In LAC 3.1, we added support for the new VTX A12W speaker. The A12W is identical to the A12 in all aspects, with the exception of the horizontal coverage. An A12W produces a wider 120-degree horizontal coverage, where the A12 is a 90-degree system. The VTX A12W can be used in a standalone array or in combination arrays with the 90-degree A12s. To select an A12W, first select the VTX A12 in the System Selection menu, and then use the Speaker Type drop-down boxes to construct the exact configuration needed. Note that an A12 and an A12W cannot be used as part of the same circuit group. In LAC version 3.2, we added support for the new VTX A8 and VTX B18 products, along with a number of supported suspension accessories. VTX A8s can be used to create standalone arrays or in combination with arrays with B18s at the top and A8s below. B18 subwoofers can be set to normal front-firing mode or as rear-firing cardioid for maximum rejection behind the array. All VTX A8 suspension accessories, like the array frame and suspension bar, are compatible with both the A8 and the B18. visualizing your array inside of other drafting programs to ensure your sound system fits into the broader production goals and needs has taken a huge leap forward with the ability to export your arrays into 3D DXF files. With this new feature, you'll be able to share your plan with industry standard drafting programs that fit within your team's production workflow. After you have built and designed your array, simply find the Export to DXF option under the main menu. The exported drawings include both speakers and array frames. The file's measurement unit type is set in the default unit section of the application options. They are fully compatible with all programs that support 3D DXFs like Vectorworks, AutoCAD, and SketchUp Pro. Here at JBL, we continue to improve and refine the tools to help you be successful. If you have any additional questions or feature requests, please let us know. Thank you for watching.